first alter, yeah.
The first alter. Seyed, Hossein, Mahdavi.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. My name is Seyed Hossein Mahdavi. I am from Structural Health Monitoring, Reliability and Safety Group, Department of Civil Engineering, University of Malaya, for Lumpur, Malaysia. And in this section, I would like to present a short part of my findings on a PhD entitled A Wavelet-Based Scheme for Optimum Measurement, Monitoring of Dynamic Responsible Structures. Let me to start here. One of the controversial challenges in structural health monitoring is data measurement. In actual and real problems, in order to accomplish a reliable identification and dynamic detection, most of the time, a set of large data points are considered. Furthermore, in order to precisely capture the entire detailed structural responses, the use of large sampling rates, very, very short time intervals, is preferred in order to capture all details of responses. Particularly, I'm talking about frequency contents. Undoubtedly, the development of an optimum scheme for structural simulation in achieving to a cost-effective strategy for structural health monitoring is essential. It should be optimal. In fact, structural dynamics problems are categorized into two main categories. The first one are structural simulation or direct analysis. We have a set of inputs and the goal is to simulate output. The second category is inverse problem or structural identification, which from right to left, we have a set of measured response in terms of experimental words. Mostly it is accelerometers data, and we are recording this, for example, in my lab, we are recording these simple piezoelectric sensors for non-contact laser sensors, and the goal is to identify the unknown parameters. The main outline of my study, my presentation now, involves direct analysis, inverse analysis, and definitely wavelet functions, and the main objective of this presentation contributes to the intersection between these three circles. What's wavelet analysis? Actually, you know, wavelet analysis and the mathematical concept behind this powerful tool is a little bit boring. That's why I want to just skip slides, just highlight and address some of the very important key points for those who are interested to work on this. Definitely, they have to address these key points. The first one is transport, and what is the importance of transport, and then Fourier transform. We have many class of Fourier transform. We have a lot of equations, and just I'm so sorry, I skip all of them. And how Fourier transform works? How does Fourier transform work? We have a short Fourier transform, window Fourier transform, and then wavelet transform, and we can make a very, very reliable comparison between these two transforms. In the context of wavelet transform, we should be well aware about continuous and discrete wavelets, scaling and shifting, and wavelet coefficients about CW is constant wavelet transform, and wavelet coefficients for discrete wavelet transform. The main important thing is signal processing. How wavelets do they behave for processing a signal and the signal decomposition. For discrete wavelet transport, for continuous wavelet transport and discrete wavelet transport, definitely we have to compare these two contexts in order to achieve the proper simulation strategy or maybe inverse problem strategy. And one of the popular key points and topics in the use of wavelets is filtering. And for me, multi-resolution is also one of the important ones as one of the main property of wavelet transport. And we have lots of mathematical definitions in context of multi-resolution analysis. And finally, the practical model wavelets. We have lots and lots of model wavelets. We have to know that which kind of model wavelet is better for which kind of problems. And the next and the last thing is segmentation method. But, I know that it's a little bit ambiguous today, but then I want to brief you a very simple physical meaning of wavelets. how do they do? This is very simple, you know, because I know that probably this one is much more interesting. In the Vegas, for example, imagine that somebody asks you to analyze this map. This map for me is complex. It has a one x direction, it has one y, one y, and one z as the evaluation, elevation of each point in this map. This one is complex. And for me, I offer three options. The first one is I categorize this map to many, many steps and then just follow a rule from top to down, left to right, top to down, left to top, step by step. Definitely, in order to achieve a very accurate analysis, you have to shorten these steps. And there are a lot of, you know, concepts in this. And definitely, once you are using a very, very short interval, the accuracy of your result is much more reliable. The next option to analyze this map is you don't need to categorize this map. You take a magnifier or maybe several magnifiers with different index and then move these magnifiers on your map, and easily you can detect and you can just identify what's happening on your map. But the third option is that assume that we can just occupy an art with electric device, that we can put all magnifiers together with different scales and then move this system and this set of magnifiers on the map and then analyze the signal. Ladies and gentlemen, this is only the way that I can describe easily that how wavelets work. And this map is exactly, in our case, is this complex signal. It is three dimensions, x as a time, y as an amplitude, and z as a, the frequency content. It's exactly the same, but it's complex. Exactly this map, the first option, I have to use time step, delta t, or maybe in experimental sampling rates. And definitely, in order to achieve a very accurate analysis, I have to shorten these time steps. The next one is exactly the same as what I was talking about, is I can use different scales of magnifiers and just decompose my signal. This is how it would work. And the last one is to use the combination of different scales of this magnifier and move all together and just decompose the signal. This is, I think, the last one. In these definitions, wavelets are these magnifiers that I talked about. And you know, some of the mathematical things, we know that mathematically we can decompose any signal by wavelet coefficients and this size. Cite is my magnifier, which it varies from different wavelets, two-dimensional to three-dimensional. And just we have a set of simplification, I can simply find the wavelet coefficients, which for discrete and continuous will be the difference. And the next one is this star. It has some format like this. It is a square matrix and it's different to different wavelets. For example, one of them is for change of wavelet. It has a shape like this. And the next one, this one, is product matrix of indirect integration, which plays the main role for solution of differential equations. And it has a format like this. And the very important thing is that the wavelets are formulated in local time. Definitely, we have to map the data on local time to our global time to see the effect of wavelets in global time from time ti to ti plus 1. And we can only do this through to the channel isolation method by using segmentation method, using different collocation ports corresponding to the different scales of wavelets. And we can map the data from time ti to time ti plus 1. And we can use adaptive wavelet function in order to achieve adaptive analysis. I will refer to this and what does it mean, adaptive analysis. But how can we solve direct analysis in structural simulation for accessible degree of freedom? Just, I want to move very fast from this. For this problem, we know these are non-parameters. These are the main characters of the structure. And the aim is to simulate the response of the structure in terms of acceleration, velocity, and displacement. The mathematical trend is something like this. We decompose the acceleration by using wavelet coefficients and operational matrix of wavelet. It is an integration. We have to add the constants of integration and we add the constant of integration with each of them. And for different scales of wavelet, we can simulate this problem and just substitute a noun value. And it is just mathematical algebraic simplification and then find C W T from here? Simply, we can put C as a coefficient wavelet in our base formulation. We can develop acceleration, velocity, and U. This is very important. It should be kept in mind that the robustness of this technique is that for different sampling rates, we can different collocation points corresponding to different scales of wavelets. What does it mean? It means that when you are encountering